It's a public health crisis that shows no signs of slowing down. But the road to addiction often starts where you may not expect.
The addiction clearly can start at the doctor's office. In fact, in my experience, I think that's been the majority of the time.
Prescription pills, often the quick fix, but if it can put you at risk of addiction, is it worth it?
Is there something else that we can use instead? We're really doing that hard work of trying to crack down, whereas before we were saying, okay, let's try to treat people's pain more aggressively. It led to us using these medications more. Now we're in an epidemic and we need to really crank it down.
Dr. Christine Alexander with Metro Health says there are alternatives to painkillers, often linked to heroin abuse, like massages, yoga, or anti-inflammatory drugs.
The other therapies are not going to give them that same sense of relaxation and relief. And I think it's helping the patient to understand that that sense of relaxation and relief is the sort of thing that's going to lead to the addiction.
Ohio Governor John Kasich recently announced new restrictions on prescribing prescription painkillers for short-term pain. It would limit doctors from prescribing no more than a 7-day supply for adults.
There's always something we find out that we need to do that can help us to get on top of this. And we have made progress, make no mistake, but the progress isn't enough.
The Cuyahoga County Medical Examiner's Office says at least 61 people died in February due to heroin or fentanyl overdoses. While the governor's actions to help combat the crisis are welcomed, Dr. Alexander says some patients only need a small dose of opiates to start down the deadly path of abuse.
The really tough part, though, is that for patients, even getting a small amount is going to give them that same response. These are very quick-acting medicines. So one or two doses can be enough to kind of flip that switch for certain patients.